Thank you, Kavita. So I'll try to rush through quickly because we don't have much time and we shouldn't impinge onto the next session. Well, research starts with a question and or a problem. So it could either be a clinical question or a surgical or a diagnostic question, or it could be some problem area. Now, questions which could be very simple, like, which molecule is better as a lubricant, a CMC or a sodium hyaluronate, or a diagnostic problem as to which topographer can diagnose progression better in KC and which is the best. So these are some very basic clinical questions we can encounter all the time. So we can do either a retrospective study, go back to the patient folders and try and find out an answer. Or if you don't get an answer, you could always plan a prospective study and find out the answer for yourself. Only thing, you will have to figure out the right study design, etc., and other details. And regarding clinical trials, well, clinical trial is defined as any research study which prospectively assigns human participants or groups of humans to one or more health-related intervention to evaluate the effect on health outcomes. And you need to register with the clinical trials website. It is expensive, but you can always get funding from the government or from the pharma industry and do it. But today I'm not going to talk about this. I'm going to talk about basic research and basic research which always deals with a problem area. So what is a problem area? Just to give an example, maybe something like say the drug penetration into the vitreous cavity is poor for topically applied medications, and so you need to give intravitreal injections is the only way to treat these conditions, but then they come with complications like RD, etc. So the question is, can we create a topical formulation which can penetrate into the vitreous cavity so that you can completely avoid injections? Well, to answer this, you need to go back to the bench for some real innovation. Certain other examples, say for example, when we do bilateral limbal stem cell deficiency cases, instead of harvesting stem cells from a life-related donor, which will need lifelong immunosuppression, can we harvest the stem cells from a source that is least antigenic potential? So these are some very major questions that cannot be solved in the clinic, and you need to go into the lab. So back to the bench research is basically a basic science research that can answer question, beliefs, or practices which are prevalent for decades, but it can also create new frontiers that were unknown before. And if successful, we can bring in a huge change in the way we practice. However, it needs few things. That is what is the important to remember is, first and foremost, the most important thing is the problem or the question that you're trying to address. So without a problem, there will be no answer. So the problem is extremely important. And once you have a problem, you should also have an idea or a potential idea that you think can, solve the problem. And now that you have had an idea, since you alone, we are all doctors, so we often need other people, say scientists or other technical people. So you need them as collaborators to, make that idea come into reality. You need to plan, detail study plan as to what you're going to do, your study questions, as well as the budget. You also need to organize for funding and make sure you need to take time off from your clinical work, and needs a lot of patience and maybe sometimes years and decades, and never say die attitude. No matter what happens, you keep going. So our story, I'd just like to share that we started with a problem area, which is poor treatment outcome in fungal keratitis due to, non-availability of good antifungals. We felt that some innovation is required in this area to improve the outcomes and reduce the occurrence of monocular blindness due to fungal keratitis, especially in the agricultural workers in the developing countries like India. So we collaborated with Indian scientists from IIT Delhi. We created a plan and a budget. We approached funding. The first time we approached, we were rejected. Second time again we approached, so we were fortunate enough to get a grant from the Department of Biotechnology. It took us 2 years for the funding to come, but that doesn't matter. You still keep working. And we created our team, which included clinician, that was me, with scientists from IIT Delhi. We had a microbiologist, and we also had research students. And we could also use the funding to set up our lab for the microbiological studies here. And we came up with this paper, and we could demonstrate that we could create a novel formulation of natamycin along with peptides, which could penetrate the corneal epithelium in vitro and also with good antifungal efficacy. This we published. So Next came the next challenge, which was to demonstrate the same efficacy in vivo, that is in animals. So we had a long wait of almost 3 years, but we are fortunate enough to find collaborators from the National Institute of Biologicals, Noida, which is an excellent government-run animal lab. And we were also lucky to get funding from the DST. And this work we started in 2017, and we concluded last year, and we have been successful in showing to demonstrate the antifungal efficacy of natamycin was found to be 3 times higher than the natamycin alone, and also it showed our conjugate showed very much higher corneal penetration. This is the paper which we published last month. So the current status is that we are in the process of collaboration with the industry for a clinical trial on humans on this. Couple of other advantages, we got a couple of best paper awards, we got few oral presentations, both international and national meetings. And since it is science and research, once you have your team, so you always end up, branching out into, other things. So we are currently working on few other areas of ocular drug delivery, and that's the photograph which we took at NIB Noida with my team. And to summarize, research is in your clinical practice definitely a possibility. Must remove the mental block that we often feel that research cannot be done unless you are in an academic institution. All you need is a very deep commitment and focus on your research goal. Create your own team, make sure to keep time for the research, and you can always make it happen. And I'd like to close with this very inspiring quote or reference to Professor Dolman. As we all know, that he is the one who gave us the Boston keratoprosthesis, but most of us possibly don't know that the first paper describing the device which he published was in 1978, but he continued to work for more than 16 years and refining and re-refining the device till it got US FDA approval in 1994. And even today he sits with his team and is continuously trying to improvise the device. So that's what is research. Thank you so much.